I come under point of order 15.
And read, read.
Of removing every form of ambiguity and for the clarity of definition. I want to take order 14 first. Privileges are the rights enjoyed by the Senate collectively and by the members of the Senate individually, conferred by the legislative houses, powers and privileges, Act Cap 208 laws of the Federation 1919 and other statutes, or by practice, precedent, usage, and custom. B, whenever a matter of privilege arises, it shall be taken up immediately. And I will go to order 15. Any senator may rise at any time to speak upon a matter of privilege suddenly arising, and he shall be prepared to move without notice a motion declaring that a content of breach of privilege has been committed. I will stop there, Mr. President. My name is Senator Matthew Urhoghide. I represent Edo South and Tedap District in Edo State. Mr. President, distinguished colleagues, I want to quickly draw your attention to a publication that I saw in Daily Trust of 28th of June, 2016. I will refer you to page 3 of this publication. And on account of the earpiece on page 3, constituency projects may suffer setback SGF. Mr. President, after I read through this piece, there were two portions that were a bit difficult for me to understand, and by the time I subjected it to ordinary interpretation based on my understanding, I found out that my representation here is being threatened. Mr. President, what was mentioned by the SGF here is very clear and put succinctly. He has said that all the zonal intervention projects that of course have been approved in this year's budget, as of course as documented by the federal government on this document, which of course has to do with the budget of national planning and zonal intervention projects, which is here. I want to say, Mr. President, distinguished colleagues, he has said very clearly here that constituency projects may not be executed. He has said very clearly here, and I want to read, if you permit me, Mr. President, that government might find it difficult to implement the constituency projects to the letter because NDAs might not find constituency projects as critical to the execution of their mandate. And given the building resources, this could be some of the areas that will suffer during implementation. Of course, the end of that interview of press briefing by him says, it is obvious that it can only implement that for which we have money. And I think these are some areas that might suffer from the implementation of the budget, he said. Mr. President, I want to say, with every element of responsibility, that one of the statutory roles that we have to play here is to represent our constituencies. Mr. President, I want to say that the 2016 budget that came to this hallowed chamber, as presented by Mr. President, has suffered a whole lot of back and forth interventions or buffeting. At the end of it, all that budget was passed by the Senate and by the National Assembly, and was signed into law by Mr. President. I want to say that the zonal intervention project that Mr. President brought to the National Assembly had a value of about 60 billion in a budget of over 6 trillion, meaning that what was given to us as intervention projects on behalf of our constituencies is less than 1% of this year's budget. Then for the SGF, who of course sees the inner recess of the mind of Mr. President to say that the constituency projects that we have in this year's budget will not be implemented to the letter. If he says, I think there's cause for worry. And I'm very worried. Mr. President, I want to say that immediately after this budget was passed, myself, as a very credible representative of my constituency, I went ahead and I published this, and I went to give account of one year of my representation here in the Senate. And I have enumerated all my constituency projects here as contained, and I have prepared fervently that these projects will be implemented. When I mentioned it to my constituents, it was with ecstatic jubilation that they said for the very first time, federal government of Nigeria is going to provide their very basic needs within the nooks and crannies and the hamlets of my constituency. And for SGF, Babacha David Lawal, who is the secretary to the governor of the federation, to say that this part of this budget will not be implemented, it only means that distress, underdevelopment, and such negative superlatives will be portioned of my people, but God forbid. I want to say, Mr. President, distinguished colleagues, that this 2016, if the SGF has mentioned this, and then the hope of our people dashed, I want to cite just two examples of this constituency project. Mr. President, distinguished colleagues, while I was campaigning in one hamlet called Eho in the whole local government area, a woman cried and told me that we will vote for you. When we vote for you, please save us the agony of loss, because it takes us over 2 hours and on a bad road of over 50 kilometers to go from Eho to get to Irua, where you have a federal facility. And many of them have died on the way. And I pray fervently that I'll be able to make the provision of mortality for them in that neighborhood. And it is here. It is in this budget. That's my constituency project. And when I went there and I mentioned it to them that they're going to have a mortality facility, they received it with joy. Another widow in the Kweniro, in the whole local government area, told me that they had lost, in fact, that she lost the only daughter when we were trying to cross the road to the other side to attend secondary school, because they have no secondary education on the other side, because they had to cross 8 lanes. And I prayed and I put in my constituency project that a block of classroom secondary school be built on that side. It is here. Now SGF has said that it will not be implemented. What is the hope of my people? And for the SGF to say, Mr. President, is that he's speaking the mind of Mr. President himself. And I want to say, we must be reminded at this point, that this document, Mr. President, when passed and assented to by Mr. President, is a law. It becomes a law. Any part in the implementation of this document, of this budget, is a violation of the law. Not implementing it to the fullest is a violation of the law. People have violated budgets. An appropriation act people have violated in this country. We must know that it is an impeachable offense to violate this law. And we will not allow this budget as a law now to be violated this year. Enough is enough. Mr. President, let me quickly say that if the SGF has mentioned that the budget will not be implemented to the letter as expressed in that publication, it only means that there is going to be selective implementation of constituency project this year. Then, of course, for those of us, particularly me, who is from one little hamlet of a people who have been oppressed and repressed all these years, we have no hope. Secondly, it is a pointer to effect that this year's budget, the purposes of its implementation is negative already. We will not be able to achieve maximum budget implementation this year. For a budget of less than 1%, you have said we are not going to implement it.
0.01%.
And then again, Mr. President, I want to look at the human psychology that is involved in this press briefing that the SGF gave. He has shown so much disdain and hatred for the National Assembly. This is the reason. There is no way you can go to an infinitesimal fraction of a budget of less than 1%. And you are picked out the National Assembly. And you know that we are the ones that really, truly are really represent the people. Every person here in the Senate, the 109 of us, and the 360 of them in the House of Representatives, if you put it together, we truly represent the people. And it is our statutory role and duty to make sure that these people are properly represented. Mr. President, distinguished colleagues, please for those to allay my fear. I'm moving the motion right now based on this. That the SGF be summoned within the shortest possible time, within 48 hours to come and explain to us what it means by the press briefing. So that you can allay my fears. I'm very worried. I have been disoriented by the pronouncement. And you need to protect me. This lady needs to protect me and protect my constituents. If it does not come here to explain it, it only means that the implementation of this year's budget will not be achieved. I want to thank you for the privilege. Thank you very much and God bless you.
Center.